Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this new episode of Swift Quiz. This time, I want to talk about a topic called variable shadowing. So let me show you some code. You can see I've defined a function that takes a closure as an argument and then executes that closure. But you can see that inside the function, I've defined another function with the exact same name than the closure argument. Now let's imagine that I call my function run. My question is, what do you think this code will do? Will it print A? Will it print B? Will it actually fail to compile? Before I give you the answer, let me know in the comments what was your initial thought. So let's start with the question of whether this code builds. Yes, this code builds. Defining a function within another function is not a very common pattern. I think I might have used it only once, but it is a valid Swift syntax. Now the question of what this code prints. Let's run the code and see what happens. We can see the code prints B, which means that what gets executed is the internal function and not the closure we passed as an argument. The reason for this is the mechanism I mentioned in the intro of the video called variable shadowing. This mechanism allows us to define a new variable with the same name than a variable that already exists in an outer scope. It can be very useful. For instance, if we want to mutate the value of an argument inside a function, but keep referring to it using the same name, like in this new example. However, this shadowing mechanism also leads to less obvious edge cases, like the one I've just showed you, where a closure argument can be shadowed by an internal function. What's also interesting is that this behavior actually changed over time. In older versions of Swift, the internal function wouldn't have shadowed the closure, and this code would have printed A. But this was changed to the current behavior so that the shadowing mechanism would be consistent across argument types. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it and that you've learned something new. Remember to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next one. Thank you for watching and see you next time.